Professor and I made a new friend today who was not quite what either of us expected. Jackson had invited Melissa to his home for the first time. Naturally, I went with her to visit. In his bedroom was a pot plant that stood on a shelf by a windowsill. Instantly, I was intrigued and flew to the shelf to take a closer look. I've seen many plants before, but nothing like this one. It quivered a lot and rustled its needle-thin foliage. Sometimes it would even squeal, and when I heard this, I squealed back. I flew off Melissa's shoulder, where I had been perched, and landed on the shelf next to the pot and walked around it, inspecting the plant. Melissa was intrigued too, and together we studied it. Jackson showed no interest at all in his boring old plant and was busy playing a noisy game on a big screen. He kept calling Melissa to play her turn, but Melissa's focus never completely left the plant. "Does it always squeal like that?" Melissa asked. Jackson had no idea what she was talking about. "I don't think he's paid enough attention to it to hear or see anything it does." The plant shifted a little to make room on the edge of the pot. I took it as an invitation to hop onto it. Then we engaged in a conversation. I had no idea what it was saying, but it was fun to mimic the sound it made. I nibbled on one of its needles and it shrieked, ripping it away from my beak. It gave me such a fright that I jumped, madly flapping my wings. I lifted away from the pot and hovered, and then when the plant calmed down, I thought it was safe to land. This time, I descended onto the plant, but as I landed, it gave way from underneath me, and I crashed to the floor. As I puffed up my feathers and shook off the shock of it, I heard the plant make short, sharp squeaks that sounded like laughter. I joined in with a loud laugh that made Melissa cover her ears. "Squawk!" she cried. The laughter was infectious. And as soon as she realized what was funny, she too was laughing. "Shush!" she finally hissed, and I took flight, again landing on the edge of the pot where the plant had made space. Finally, Jackson took his attention away from his game to the plant and told Melissa everything he knew about it, which wasn't much, except that he came from a place far away from here and needed special care. Then, clever Melissa said, "I think his name is Shrub, and he wants to go home."